2019 Leaving Cert Higher Level Paper 2 Question 8 was a statistics question. You're told that a motoring magazine collected data on cars on a particular stretch of road. Certain details on 800 cars were recorded. So my N. The ages of 800 cars, 174 of them were new, which is less than a year old in this study. Find a 95% confidence interval for the proportion of new cars on this road. Give your answer correct to four significant figures. So we're dealing with confidence interval here. And we also have a proportion. 174 of them out of 800 were new, and 174 divided by 800 gives us 0.2175. So what we want to look at here, we want to look at our formula for proportion, which is P times 1 minus P over N, and the square root of all that. So we have the other side of 0.2175. If that's my proportion, my 1 minus P is 1 minus 0.2175, which is going to give us 0.7825. So we're testing this figure. Is this the real figure? So we're going to take 0.2175 and then we're going to add and subtract my 95% confidence interval, 1.96, by the square root of that guy, which is 0.2175 by 0.7825 divided by my N, which was 800. So this is going to give me 0.0286, and we're going to have to add and subtract that away from 0.2175. So 0.2175 plus 0.0286 will give me one side of it, and 0.2175 minus 0.0286 will give me the other side of it, and those two values are four significant figures, 0.24617. I'm getting, so 62, and on the other side, 0.1889. So we can say with 95% confidence that my p-value will be between 18.89% or 0.1889 and 0.2462. So this is the answer to part one. So part two, we're told that the data of these 800 cards is recorded and normally distributed. So once we see normally distributed, we're thinking this curve here, our standard normal distribution, which will lead us to Z scores. The average speed is 87.3. So I think it's always handy within these questions to do a little diagram and put your average obviously in the middle. The standard deviation is 12 kilometers an hour. What proportion of cars would you expect to be fined traveling at over 95? So let's pretend that 95 is here. So we're looking for this section in here. So 95. So this brings us to our Z score, our one test. So we're testing our test minus the average divided by the standard deviation is our Z score. So fill this information in here. We're testing 95 against an average of 87.3 with a standard deviation of 12. And that, if we type it into our calculator, is going to give us 0.6417, which if we go to the Z score in the formula booklet, my Z score is going to be 0.7389. So just go to 0.64. So that would be the data on the left hand side here. This is going to be what percentage? 73.89% in here will be less than 95. So we're looking for this tail in here. So it's going to be 1 minus 0.7389. So we would expect 0.2611 or 26.11% of people to be greater than 95 kilometers an hour. And remember, speed kills. So part three, we're told the driver was stopped and told that of all speeds recorded, 70% were higher than his. Find the speed the driver was recorded at. So I think let's just do a little diagram again. So here's the average, which is 50% either side. So he's over this side because 70% were higher than him. So what we need to do is we need to go to the z-score table and find 70% in there. So if we go to the z-score table and go to 0.5, we'll see that 70% lies in between here, 6985 and 7019. Now it's approximately halfway between. So 0.525 would be a little bit more accurate. You don't have to do this at Leaving Cert. You can take either of these scores. So the 0.02 is closer, so that's the one that they want you to take. But this is better maths to take closer to the exact score. Now, because he's in here, we know that it's minus. So this is going to be minus 0.525. That's what my Z score, when we calculate it, we're doing this in reverse. So we don't know this number. So let's call that X. Minus 87.3. Divided by 12 is going to give us minus 0.525. So X is equal to 12 by minus 0.525 plus 87.3. If we type that into our calculator, we're going to get exactly 81 kilometers an hour. So Z score, when we're given the percentage, go to the tables first. So the second part, or part B, part one, is quite long-winded, but a very simple explanation. A road safety program is carried out in the area using posters, signs, and radio slots. After the program, the Motoring magazine recorded the speeds of 100 passing cars. The magazine carried out a hypothesis test at the 5% level of significance to determine whether the average speed had changed. The p-value of the test was 0.024. So what are they trying to ask here? They're asking, what can the magazine conclude based on this p-value and give a reason? So let's just have a look at what that p-value represents. P-values are the tails. So if one of the tails is 0.024, then the two of them together is 0.048. Now, to be inside, to be confident that this are, well, let's take our H0, our hypothesis that speeds haven't changed. So they're testing if the speeds have changed. So our null hypothesis is that the speeds haven't changed. To be inside this 95% in here, this figure would have to be greater than 0.05. So as 0.048 is less than 0.05, we can actually say here that the magazine can conclude that the speeds have changed, or the average speeds have changed. I've actually misread this question. It's the overall p-value was 0.024, which would make, just come down here again, each tail would be, it's not going to change our conclusion, but each tail would be 0.012. So just a slight error there, but that will still, the 0.024 is still less than 0.05, so we can conclude that the average speeds have changed. And this leads us into the last part of the question, to find what the average speed was of this test that they had done. So what we need to do is we need to go, if this is 0.012, 1 minus 0.012 is equal to 0.988. So we need to go to the z-score table and find what this gives us. So the second part of this question is that the magazine found the average speed of this sample was lower than the previous established one. So when we're looking up this 0.988, we're looking at this side, it's lower than the average speed. And that gives us a z-score, well, the reverse of a z-score, looking at the tables here, of 2.26. So we'll have to take the minus version of that over here. If the speeds, if they found the speeds were higher, we do exactly the same thing, but we just take the plus 2.26. So that's going to be equal to whatever the speed was they found, minus the average, divided by, now it was a sample. How many was in the sample? Did we write it down? 100 cars. Okay. So because we have this sample, we're going to divide by standard deviation over the square root of n, which is the square root of 100. So we're going to get 12 divided by 10, 1.2 by minus 2.26 is equal to x minus 87.3. So x is equal to 1.2 by minus 2.26 plus 87.3. That's going to give us x being 84, round off to one decimal, 6 kilometers per hour.